Hello, and welcome to the Reactor. What am I doing? It's time to get serious here. All right, we're going to get to the next tune in Blackwater Park, which is Bleak. Now, this doesn't sound too uplifting or happy. That is the theme of Opeth, though, to bring you to this place of uneasiness and despair and riding the edge of visual craziness. So as the first tune I did, I guess I was kind of on par with what the lyrics were, even though I don't know any of the lyrics or what the song was about. I guess I guessed pretty good. I guessed. So, all right, well, let's see what Bleak brings to the mind of my own self, and I'll see if I can interpret it in a musical way that makes sense for whatever their intent was. Maybe. Does that make sense? I don't know. I just sound like some madman. And dudettes, can we just say that this is the best 2 minutes of any song ever written? I mean, oh my god, oh, the sustain in this. Let's try to figure this out here. So the, oh man, I gotta hear this again. Hold on. Let me pause. I'm going to listen to that again and try to get a clear picture of what's going on here. Hold on. Okay. So I just listened to that again. The beginning of this, really freaky. So you have this pretty heavy beginning part, but the acoustic part that they brought in the very beginning had this really out of tune, kind of like really threw things off. Really weird. So that was like, what is going on here? So it kind of makes your brain go, what are you doing? And then these really long sustained notes just kind of holding on for this. And then every measure, it's just this, in this long sustain. And then you have this nice riff and then this long sustain. It's fucking beautiful. So just in the first 2 minutes of this song, I feel like I am running away. I am, I'm like losing my brain. I got to get out of here. I'm going to run to a place where no one can find me. Now, this may be for everyone different, but I'm going to the woods. I'm taking off into the trees, and where nothing but other weird things exist. And I am the only human being that exists within this realm. So, whew, damn. All right, so far, I've taken off into the woods because shit's just got real. All right, so now this transition here is goddamn gorgeous. Fast inside your ears. So another transition here. This is where this particular moment takes me to friends. Friends are coming for me or helping me or trying to help me. They're trying to find out where I am. I took off. And this is where, you know, there's a part of being human where you want to be left alone. And there's a part of being human where you want to help those that are having trouble. And there's a bit of a dilemma where, are you interfering too much, or are you, you know, just letting them be? So let them be. Maybe they'll self-harm. If you interfere too much, maybe you'll push them the wrong direction. But on the other hand, if you don't help them and they do something, then you'll feel guilty. So this is that moment. To me, this is a bit of, if this were hitting me personally, I would be the one wanting to be left alone. Just let me sit in the muck. Let me just sit in the shit, and we'll see if I can crawl out of it. Yeah. All right. So that's that part. All right, here we go. Nice. That tone that just rides along. Fuckers to leave me alone. Okay. Whoa, take a breath. That hit hard. That hit really hard. Just that really higher tone that was in the not in the background, but in this, it was weaving in and out of this. It was like a guitar noise, a guitar sound, I don't know what I want to, what frequency it's in, but it's really, it makes me anxious to hear that tone throughout this whole song. And the rhythm in this, the basically the power chords throughout most of this song, and also to the vocals are in different realms where there's kind of still this argument is happening. And there was a moment there where I was like, you pushed me too far. You just didn't leave me alone. You should have just left me alone. And that's where I started feeling this song really took me back to those years where, you know, when you're a teenager, you have these emotions that are just sometimes overwhelming and you don't know why. And just the smallest thing would just set you off and just, you'd go apeshit. You'd lose your mind. You'd be like, I can't take it. This is nuts. The teacher said I didn't put a dot after the end of a sentence. I'm fucking done, right? So, shit like that. And then, you know, not to mention, if you ever got, rejected in some way, it's devastating. So this to me, it brings me back to my teenage years where those emotions were just so overwhelming, and my peers were trying to do their best to help me out, and I was just a lost cause. Maybe, I'm trying to put myself in the picture or put myself in the footstep of someone else here, but just trying to guess what emotions teenagers go through, and going through it myself. And who knows what this song is about? I don't exactly know, but it feels like to me that it was some sort of despair, bleak. It's a moment of desperation, and at some point, I think, once you come through the other side, then you can just take a breath, get back to normalcy for a little bit. What a wild tune. Just really emotionally charged. So far, this album is really super emotional, and brings me back to a day when I felt that kind of emotion, whether it be rejection or overwhelming, just teenager shit. All right, man, this is a rough album to get through. If you really just soak it in and take it personally, take a ride. And enjoy the tunes, but try not to take it too personally, okay? Until the next time, cheerio!